watching Rescue Team in Action. Department of Los Angeles County. 5.5 million people in this area are dependent on their ability to act swiftly and efficiently in any emergency. This program is dedicated to rescue teams throughout the United States and to the men who risk their lives daily to save others. We will be back in a moment to bring you the story behind this exciting rescue.
Glenn, better make it 2 quarts this morning.
Oh?
Yeah. My kid brother just got back from school.
Larry, how is he?
Oh, fine. Just fine.
You want 2 quarts all summer?
Yeah, just...
I mean, he's gonna stick around.
Oh, sure. He'll be around all summer this time. We're gonna work together.
Okay, so it's 2 quarts.
I'll see you. You missed my cooking, huh?
Yeah, if you say so, yeah.
Nobody can scramble eggs like me.
Oh, that's right.
Hey, how about that?
Lots of salt and pepper is my secret. And serve them easy. I bet you're sick and tired of that college food, aren't you?
Boy, a Ferrari. $18,500.
It's like old times, huh, Larry? Come on, now, eat them while they're hot. No good if they get cold.
Yes, sir, that's for me. A Ferrari.
Ferrari, huh? You can have one.
Oh, yeah? How?
Save your money.
Oh, that's great. Pushing ice around in someone's factory for $8 a day.
Oh, look, boy, there's nothing wrong with working for somebody. If you use your hands or your strength, so long as you do it honestly.
Yeah, just so long as you don't use your brain, right?
Oh, wait just a minute. Boy, what do you think pays the rent around here or sent you to college or buys those eggs? It's because I push ice around in somebody's factory, that's what. Or maybe you have some other ideas. Go ahead, tell me, boy, tell me.
Skip it.
No, I don't want to skip it. I'm going to settle this thing right here and now.
Look, look, I'm going to contribute my share. I'm going to work all summer pushing ice around so I can go back to school in the fall and not have to push ice next summer. All right?
Huh? But it's your attitude, Larry. Your attitude. Ever since you've been home from school, you... Go ahead and eat your eggs or we'll be late for work.
In 30 seconds ever elapses. Today we got away in 22. The earthquake had started the fire in the worst possible place, the Universal Ice Company. The dispatch dispatcher told us the ice plant used liquid ammonia as their refrigerant. The quake had caused a leak in the system. Most people, Skip included, don't know much about ammonia. It's better that way, but I do. And I'd rather jump into a pool of sharks in a room with leaking ammonia. The plant superintendent told us the quake had shorted the compressors. They were smoking dangerously. That turned out to be the least of our problems. Pipes had split, and somewhere in that ammonia trap was a man, a plant engineer who had been thrown from the catwalk by the force of the quake and was held prisoner by a wall of deadly gas. We had to get him out. Ammonia vapor is a sneaky opponent, attacking any exposed area. Petroleum jelly would protect the vulnerable spots.
Scout, Skip.
Sealing trousers and sleeves would prevent exposure to serious burns. Smoke from the burned out compressors, but there was enough ammonia gas blended into it to make our job an urgent one.
Higher than there, Skip.
Getting a shower, a life-saving shower.
He needs more than oxygen, Skip. He needs antitoxin. If he's been in there much more than 20 minutes, it'll be a miracle if he pulls through.
Rescue 8 to LA at scene. Victim, maximum exposure to NH3, group 2 toxic. Need ambulance now.
10-4, rescue 8.
Hey! Hey! We checked the entire place. Everybody's out except three men and one of the ice walls. We must have jammed the door. We can't seem to get it open. There's 8 below in there. We alternate shifts every 10 minutes. These three have been in there 15 minutes already. Stay here, Skip.
Who's trapped, Mr. Desmond?
Jenkins and the Reynolds brothers.
I'll bet that Reynolds kid is climbing the wall right now.
Hey, it's okay. He'll be all right. All right, Larry, give me a hand with Tom here. We'll move him away from this wall in case we have another shake.
How much more can you do? Look, Jeff, we've got to think about ourselves, huh? I mean, I can't take much more of this cold.
How do you think poor Tom here feels?
Well, that is Tom's problem. I'm getting up.
Larry! Tell me what Tom is.
Go ahead. You're such a big man. You handle it.
Don't make me any more ashamed of you than I already am. Now, we're all going to go out of here at the same time, you hear?
Oh,
Don't worry, boy. I'll get you out of here. Listen to
me. No, I don't want to listen to you. That's what got me here in the first place.
Now, you do what I tell you, youngster. Now.
Jack can open jam doors or almost move a mountain.
As far as she'll go.
Let me get this off.
Get my partner over right away. He'll bring this door wider.
This room and everyone in it to the ammonia killer.
Oh, you're gonna be all right. I'm gonna be all right. You'll be out of here before you know it.
What happened to him?
Quake knocked him off balance and fell into the ice scoring machine. A contraption like that can cut a man up pretty badly.
I guess I don't have to tell you about that ammonia gas.
No, sir.
Well, what about ammonia gas?
Once you start breathing it, you can take about 20 minutes of it. That could be the worst and last 20 minutes of your life.
There's a cutoff valve down front there. It controls all the liquid ammonia in these pipes here.
Must be pretty high up. Is there a ladder or anything else around here we can use to get to it?
No, we don't. Hop on the fork. I'll give you a boost up.
Dark chip. Nice. A lot of little pieces. Pile it right here. Let me have your jacket.
Why?
Come on, we're fighting seconds. If you want to get out of here alive, do what I tell you to do.
What do you want the kid's jacket for?
I want it for you.
I'm okay. Let the kid keep it.
You're going into that cloud of gas. I want you covered as much as possible. Come on, come on. I'll zip it up.
Yes, sir.
I'll tuck your breeches and your boots. Move up under the valve, then lift them until I can reach the ceiling. And when you get into that stuff, keep your eyes squinted.
Right.
Down, help you.
No! No! Hurry!
Come on, keep shipping, boy.
Take it.
Liquid ammonia had bitten through his glove like a white-hot flame.
All right.
It's the best I can do for you right now. This liquid ammonia is worse than a third-degree burn. Water is the only thing that will dissolve it. This ice is the nearest thing we've got to water.
I'll be okay. Don't worry about me. We ain't had much chance to introduce ourselves, have we?
No.
I'm Jeff Reynolds. That's my kid brother, Larry, over there.
I'm Wes Cameron.
Larry, he ain't used to working with us here. He's a college boy.
You don't have to apologize for me.
That's right, Larry, he doesn't. Keep your eyes squinted. Tears will keep the ammonia out.
We're going to move him back to Jenkins. Give me a hand, will you?
Then we're... I'm okay.
I don't know, kid, we'll figure out something. Give me a hand.
Yeah, sure. Larry! Stop him, he'll kill himself.
Tom Jenkins.
I didn't mean it. You believe me, don't you?
I didn't mean this, Jeff.
Get on that leg and hold it straight. Come on, get a move on.
You know I didn't mean
it. Right now.
Jeff, I swear to you.
Every ammonia pipe in the place. There's got to be another way.
You think you can operate that truck now? I don't mean bounce it off the walls. I mean work with it.
I never tried.
You're about to, because we're going to take a flyer at something.
We're going to build a wall between us and that gas.
If we still have time.
With what?
Ice. How much does one of these weigh?
300 pounds.
That's why we'll need the truck to lift them.
This ceiling must be about 8 feet high.
If we can stack these blocks high enough, we might just stop that gas.
But won't the gas leak through?
It's like I said, ammonia dissolves 100% in water. I'm just hoping there's enough water on the surface of these blocks to keep that gas from crawling that wall.
Now, we'll start it right about in here, just ahead of the gas.
We don't have much time, kid. I'll slide the blocks in for the foundation, and you operate the truck.
But I can't. I don't know how to handle the thing.
All right, Jeff, you tell him what to do while he's doing it.
You don't understand. I...
Larry. Boy, you gotta try. I know you can't do anything with your hands. I always wanted it that way, but you gotta try this time, okay?
Yeah, just to show I can't prove it.
Oh, we're pulling together, you and me.
Yeah, you doing the pulling like always.
Larry! Ain't very pretty, is it?
I'm sorry, Jeff. I didn't mean it that way.
I want you to get back up in the truck. Work those levers and...
Shh, Mr. Cameron, you can do it.
Now, you can see how the pipe system covers most of the ceiling underneath.
Yeah, except for these two spots. I guess we better try them both.
I don't know. There's still plenty of liquid ammonia in those pipes. If you should hit them, I'd sure hate to be underneath.
guess we'll chance it here.
All right, easy now, boy. Easy up there.
You got it, Larry. You got it going good. Oh. All these years, Jeff. Jeff, I've been seeing the wrong side of things. I was thinking that I was caught right in your hands. Like I couldn't make a move unless you were holding me up. Jeff, you've got to forgive me for what I thought about you.
I can't hear you.
All these years, Jeff, ever since Papa died, ever since you took over, I've been indebted to you. How much can you owe a guy and not hate him?
I can't hear you.
Shotgun of the best rescue man in the business.
Jeff, we made it. We made it, son.
You sure did, boy.
Jeff, when we get home, I wish it hit me right in the eye.
No. You know, you were out there working. I was thinking maybe all this trouble we've had, it's been my fault.
Oh, wow. You know it isn't.
I expected too much thanks from a kid. How much thanks can a guy expect for a glass of milk or thanks for a bowl of oatmeal? How much thanks, Larry? How much?
All right.
Now watch.
Get a good and tight, Skip.
All right. Take it easy, will you? Watch.
Okay, after you go.
Watch it.
Easy does it. All right now?
Pretty close, Wes. I guess that's about the worst trap I've ever seen.
There are all kinds of traps, Skip. Some a lot worse than ammonia traps. Traps that people make for each other and for themselves.
Trying to tell me something?
No. Just thinking out loud. I'm feeling pretty good to know that you can break out if you really want to.
Not exactly.
What do you mean?
Will you see when I'm cooking up for dinner tonight? There's one trap you can't break out of.